Basketball team as well as our other athletic teams at the TD Bank Sports Center. I'm joined today by men's basketball head coach Tom Moore, and to his right is Evan Conti, Zaire Hurst, and Usman Drami. Men's basketball team appeared in their fourth national postseason tournament in the last 5 years last season, posting a 20-12 record. And as a result, Usman Drami was named to the All-MAC second team, Zaire Hurst was named to the All-MAC third team. We'll have a brief statement from Coach Moore, and then we'll open up to questions.
Should I bring this over here?
Ken,
should we look better? Sure.
Okay. Ken, can we move that one as well, please? Yep. Thank you.
Ken, slide that.
Record.
Perfect. Thank you.
There you go. You're done.
I'll also be serving lunch shortly.
Again, I reiterate what Ken said. I'd like to thank everybody for coming. We appreciate the coverage and the support and. Very exciting time of the year for us, obviously, here. It's the college basketball season. When you're in it and you're competing, it seems like it's a marathon. And then when it ends, you just want it to start again. And we're getting closer and closer to starting it again. The way the NCAA changes the rules every year, it becomes more and more vague, and it's more and more gray area as to when we technically started, when one season ends and one begins, but it's around the corner, and we've had a terrific off season since the last time I guess we sort of convened with really any of you guys, and it was after we watched a 3-point shot bank in off the. Off the glass over at Yale to be eliminated from the CIT, and dealing with the disappointment of how last season ended for us was difficult. You know, made for a difficult end of March, but we've had a great spring, and we had two terrific summer sessions, and we've had a great start to the fall since all these guys have come back, and very, very excited about our second season in the MAC, and it's mostly because of the three young men I have seated to the right here of me. Whenever you go into a season and you have three seniors like these three guys, it's a comforting feeling for a head coach because these guys have given a great deal to this program, and a lot of blood and sweat tears and sacrifice and unselfishness and commitment, and when you have seniors sort of at the head of your sleigh when you start a season that are as talented as these three are and as good of people as these three are, it gets you that much more excited about the season ahead. So I cannot wait. We have a great non-conference schedule that I think will challenge us. The MAC will obviously again challenge us, and I'm excited about the direction of the program. And I can't express enough how rewarding it is to again be able to work with these three guys for their fourth years. And I've spoken about this a lot over the years. And one of the drawbacks of being at a high major school as an assistant. And the situation I was coming from at UConn, sometimes your best players and your best people would leave you after a year or 2 years or 3 years for the NBA draft. But the biggest benefit of coaching at this level is you get to develop a four-year relationship with a young man and also get to enjoy him sort of becoming the best college player he can be in his fourth year. And like I said, all three of these guys are ready to do that. So. I'll pass it along. Do you want an opening statement from, do you want anything from these guys, or do you want to take questions?
I know we're going to open up to questions now.
Okay.
One from the media for Coach Moore or any of the players.
Tom, what do you take away from your first journey through the MAC? And, you know, are there things you pick up along the way that that you can use moving forward? Do you feel better equipped this year having been through it once?
The biggest thing, Mike, for us that we took out of last year is, I think, a belief that we belong in the league. As we entered it a year ago at this time, it was like a great unknown. We had, from a coaching staff point of view, and I think our players too as well, had such respect for what Manhattans and the Ionas and the Siennas and the Fairfields, and I can't even start really where the schools in the league had done over the course of the recent past and the distant past too as well. I think I appreciated it more, and I know our administration with Jack McDonald and Billy Mecker and the people here in sports information with Ken and Tony, I think we all understood how great a tradition there was in men's basketball in the MAC. These guys aren't expected to know, you know, how good some of these teams were 20 and 30 years ago, but I do know we all, as we went into it a year ago, it was the great unknown. And we were confident because we knew we were good and we knew we were tough. We were confident it would equate, but you're not really ever sure. And the one thing we attained last year as we were rolling towards the end of February, and we had that 7-game winning streak, and we were sort of in position going into that last weekend to maybe even finish first if things had broken okay in the last weekend, was that belief. And I was talking to an assistant, another head coach yesterday on the recruiting trail about this. As a coach, you can feel that as the season was coming to an end, we had that belief that you can feel in a program and in a locker room that comes from winning in key spots of the league. You know, from you beat an Iona at home, you beat a Siena and a Manhattan and a Canisius on the road. You feel as you're going into the last couple weeks that like we belong here and we can play here. So I think what the biggest thing these guys have to impart to the new guys, and I think they've done a great job at that so far, is that what we do translates well to this league. Now, it's not going to guarantee us anything. You know, I've seen people pick us third or fourth or fifth. But I know we're in that conversation again to be one of the better teams in the league. And the success we had a year ago is going to be the biggest positive we take from last year on the MAC into this year.
Just to follow up on that, how has the recruiting trail changed for you since you joined the MAC?
It's been quite obvious, Eric, so far, what we've been able to, the level of kids we've been able to get involved with since we've joined the MAC. We just were involved with a kid that had scheduled 4 visits, and it was 3 Atlantic 10 schools and us. We can go after a higher level kid, in particular in the Northeast, in particular even more specifically in New York and New Jersey, because I just think there's such a deep-rooted history and deep-rooted tradition of MAC basketball being at a high level among the high school coaches, the AAU coaches, and even the parents of these kids, that when we are on SNY or we're on ESPNU or ESPN3 or ESPN or whatever, and it's a game against a Manhattan or an Iona or a Siena or a Fairfield or whatever, there's a really strong buzz. And I think the other thing is that with all those big conference realignments at the highest level, the other neat thing is I think the Colonial League is not seen as something that's ahead of the MAC anymore. I saw a preview magazine the other day that had us rated as the 16th best conference in the league and the CAA as the 19th. Now, 6 or 7 years ago, the CAA was rated as the 7th or 8th best league, but they lost VCU, they lost George Mason, they lost Old Dominion, and you know, now it strengthens the MAC. So as we're out there recruiting, you have kids who are looking for the old Big East, they're looking for the AAC, and then after that, they're sort of looking at the Atlantic 10, and we feel the package that we have here, that we can recruit against the Atlantic 10. It's not a thing where we feel we're going to beat them regularly, but if we only really have to beat them once every 5 or 6 kids to land that impact kid. So we've definitely noticed the change.
Questions for our student athletes?
Bruce, there was a picture over the summer with some crutches. Can you talk about your current health status?
I'm fine. I'm getting back into shape, and I'm going to start running soon. I haven't ran probably 4 months now, so I'm still rehabbing. Things like that. I had meniscus repair, which is a 5-month timetable, so I'm about 4 months in now. I'm supposed to start running within these weeks coming up, so I'll be fine in 3 months.
help you determine experience? Does it still burn a little? You went out there without Umar, and you guys were on a roll going into it.
Yeah, I mean, it still burns, you know. In the back of my head, I still remember, you know, holding my teammates, you know, trying to, you know, carry them up off the court, you know, against my head. So going in this year, like, you know, that's the chip that we're going to have on our shoulder this year, you know, just coming so close and having things running, going so well, and then, you know, just having to stop like that. We're gonna have a chip on our shoulder this year.
Tom, do you think it could be a too big league this year? Somebody goes 25-5.
Definitely, yeah. You know, it was too big. We got two bids 2 years ago or 3 years ago. And I know Tim Kloos and Steve Masiello a year ago were pretty forward and up front about being proponents of that as we got down to the end of the year. And I certainly echo that. I feel like it's we're right there, you know, and how Manhattan played in the tournament against Louisville in the first round speaks volumes to how strong the league is. And I don't think there was ever more of a commercial for us to be considered as a two-bid league than when, after that game, they kicked it back to the TNT studios and they asked Charles Barkley said, if this Manhattan team is the second best team in the league, why isn't the first place team in this tournament too? You know, he didn't even know it was Iona at the time, but it was, you know, somebody had said, he said, who's the first best place team? And why aren't they in the tournament? So you take a snippet like that and it's some national awareness. It's a great league, it's a highly competitive league, and I certainly think when you start looking at RPIs and the quality of wins, I think that we'll have at the top of this league, there's gonna be four, possibly five teams at the top that if they have real good years and they stay healthy, will be certainly NCAA bubble teams.
We'll take one more question for Coach Moore, student athletes, before we break off to one-on-ones. Any other questions?
Coach, you talked about before these four-year cycles of these players coming in, and this, I would say this is your second cycle of these four guys, the seniors you brought in 2011, and them being seniors now. How does that shape your expectations for this season when they have all that experience behind them?
You know, that's why I think we should be very good again, Vinny. You know, I expect us to be very good again because they're real good. You know, they're real good players. And not only are they good players, but they're very good kids and they're good teammates and they do what we ask them to do. They're very selfless and they bring a commitment and a drive every day that is what we want our young kids to see as they come in here. So. One of the biggest things I want to establish here, and I think so far our staff and I have done that with all the kids we've brought in, is we want to be good every year. We don't want to have those dips where you can look back at a 10 or 15 or 20 year snippet of Quinnipiac basketball and say, well, geez, they had a couple 4-1 seasons, a 5-1 season, but they really bottomed out here. Proud of the fact that of the groups we've brought in, we've never won less than 50 games, and these guys have had a ton to do with it. They've been on three, I think, real good teams and one team that probably underachieved, and they sort of know how both feel. And and I think Bill, you asked a great question of Z. And one other thing that I didn't mention, the development since March, was I named Saeed Hurst the captain of the team for this year. It was something I forgot in my opening remarks, but we've never had a captain here in my 7 years so far. He's gonna be the first captain. Wasn't voted on by the team, wasn't voted on by the staff. It was just strictly picked by me, and I just feel like we've never had anybody on and off the court so focused and driven at us achieving and him achieving a high level with him. That's I think a strong statement too as well. What a special leader and kid he's been too as well. So apologize for being long-winded. So we're gonna get 10 to 12 questions in, but you guys who cover us know me. So
that'll conclude our press conference at this time. Coach Bourne and the student athletes will be available for comment.